So right now we're just hanging out. You know, I'm not trying to do anything. You know, my friend Gabriel here is not much of an actor. He has his moments though. You know. So we're just gonna listen to some music. See how this works out. It's by this band called King Chango. The song is Santo. So what's up, man?
Not much, man. That's what I'm doing.
I'm alright. Trying to like hang in there. You know? It's not easy being the person I am to myself. That's the best way I can put it. What do you got to say, man? Forget about them. I mean, don't, but, you know, don't worry about the green light.
You say, man, things are hard.
Things are hard, right?
Life is hard.
Life is hard. Yeah. Buddha says that. Buddha says, life is dukkha dukkha. Even the joys that we have are intermixed with sorrow. There's a sense of impermanence that affects us all. Birth, old age, disease, and death. These are the cards that we have been traditionally dealt with. So you got nothing to say? I'm just gonna open up at random from the first book that I see here. Sri Vrndavana Mahimamrita. O mind, forget all seen and unseen material enjoyment. Do not meditate on the manifestation of impersonal Brahman. Do not become bewildered by material opulences. Just live in Vrindavana and search for the mellows of ecstatic love. To find fault with the land of Vrindavana is certainly an act of ignorance. To think that there is distress in Vrindavana and that Vrindavana is exhaustible is also born from illusion. But to leave Vrindavana and go somewhere else is certainly a great illusion. The brightly shining glories of Sri Vrindavana give pleasure to one's lotus-like heart. They destroy the ocean of ignorance, and they agitate the ocean of ecstatic love. All right.